A civil litigation
U.S.A.
attorney.
I'm top 10,
also a fashion blogger. I'm an extra TV correspondent as well. I'm an impact ambassador for Dress for Success. That versatility is important to a job with Miss Universe.
Hello, you guys.
If I won the title of Miss Universe, reform would expand incredibly. I would continue advocating for criminal justice reform. There are other countries
in high school and so.
So I'd love to be the proponent of change for other people in other countries as Miss Universe.
USA.
Philippines.
The next spot in our top 10 tonight.
Colombia. I worked as a lawyer. Miss Colombia, as a human being, as a woman, I have a passion towards my country, towards seeing it flourish, towards seeing it prosper. Right now in Colombia, we're getting together to change our ways. People are taking the streets, people are striking, people are asking for better opportunities in life, for better education, for less corruption, for equality. So if I was to be Miss Universe, I would go back home and I would try to unite my people.
Colombia! Also moving on to the next round.
Philippines.
Puerto Rico!
I actually come from a multicultural family. My mother is 100% born and raised Puerto Rican, and my father is European. When I moved to New York at 19 years old, I went there alone. I was in a big city. I didn't know anyone, but I was raised to love and respect diversity. And that is why I created the movement of Cebo Libro Se Llora Sangre, to inspire other people who are just like me, who don't live in your mother country, to embrace our roots and our cultures, no matter where we end up in the world. I think it's so important that we understand that we do have a place on this earth, and our identity is the essence of our hearts.
Puerto Rico, the fourth to move forward tonight.
Philippines.
South Africa.
Oh. My parents are very big on education, and so when I got financially excluded from school, that meant that I could not continue with my studies. A huge percentage of South African students were drowning in student loans, and most of us were kicked out of school. So I felt like a huge part of me was being taken away. But when one door closes, then another door opens. After being out of school for a year, I was able to learn a lot of things about myself, but also through Miss South Africa and through
wanting
to go back to school again and graduate.
South Africa. We're halfway through our top 10.
Philippines.
I announce Peru.
Lo que más me apasiona es encontrar ese potencial que tengo en mí para poder ayudar a otros, porque no hay nada más bonito que ayudar y estar en servicio. Es muy importante ayudar a los niños porque la educación es el éxito. Y los niños no solo son el futuro, sino son el presente.
Lagi pinakamalakas
si
Gaon.
Siempre creído de que si apoyamos a los niños, podemos construir una sociedad mejor, porque depende de ellos de que el mundo sea mejor. Y yo creo que cuando aportamos algo bueno para los demás,
podemos hacer una diferencia. Filipino si nang ano, pero ganda rin eh.
Also, one step closer to the crown.
Ayan.
Iceland!
Iceland, maganda rin yun ano, magaling yung salita kanina.
My name is Birta Bíbaþórsdóttir and I grew up on a farm in Iceland. When I started to compete in Miss Universe Iceland, I didn't even think about the fact that I didn't look like any of the girls that won before me. It was pointed out to me, people did not want me to win, or they would not vote for me because I didn't look Icelandic. So being able to stand up and open the discussion about how important it is that we do not all look the same was something that made this competition worthwhile to me, and it's something that made me want to win.
Iceland. The next contestant moving forward. France.
La Philippines.
Mes parents m'ont toujours bien conseillé, surtout ma mère. Elle m'a toujours dit de profiter d'elle, de la vie, de donner le meilleur de moi-même. Depuis très longtemps maintenant, je suis très engagée dans la lutte contre le cancer du sein. C'est une cause qui me touche énormément. Non, ma mère a eu un cancer du sein il y a maintenant quelques années. Et ma maman va très bien aujourd'hui. J'ai pu participer à plein d'événements, plein d'activités avec des dames atteintes de la maladie ou qui sont en rémission. Donc, on essaie de leur apporter un peu de joie dans le traitement.
France, the eighth contestant entering the next round, Indonesia.
La Philippines.
Para yung huli, no? Para nakatigawan.
I was actually one of the youngest
in the team
ever crowned. That's something that probably says me.
Vietnam,
I
serve
at the One Foundation called Voice for the Voiceless. We raise awareness of the issue that 75 million Indonesians don't have birth certificate. A birth certificate can actually really help a child's life to get health care, education, protection, and future employment. It's an issue that doesn't just affect my country, but the whole world.
Indonesia. Two spots left in the finals. One goes to Thailand.
Thailand. Top two yan eh, sa voting eh. Thailand saka Philippines.
I was a little doctor because I loved helping other people.
Philippines na yung isa.
Miss Universe Thailand. That's when I realized that, hey, there's actually a different way that I can help other people.
Pamalakas eh, silang
dalawa. I am able to help flood victims or to We Are One, my art project. It gave me an opportunity to help people. Just seeing them.
Kung hindi nalaki ng mga Philippines, maraming magagalit.
A smile, that for me is my reward.
Philippines!
11 women left, but only one spot remains, and it goes to Mexico.
Ay, hindi pasok ang Philippines, sayang.
I'm a writer and a speaker. I wrote two books about how to use science into empowering people around the world. I used to read books that my father used me to, different kinds of books about science, metaphysics. I give speeches around the country trying to explain the importance of emotional and mental health. And I just gave my first TED talk in I can use my life for really inspiring people, the importance of who they really are, my life would have absolutely.
Mexico! Let's hear it for our top 10 finalists.
Oh, sayang.
These women are quite literally the best of the best.